Hey students, in our last lecture of business research methods, we had discussed about attitude measurement scales. We have discussed about simple attitude scale and rank order scale. In this lecture, we will discuss some more scales in detail. First scale that we will discuss is constant sum. It is a measure of attitudes in which respondents are asked to divide a constant sum to indicate the relative importance of attributes. So the respondents are asked to give numbers to different attributes, and the total of those numbers should be a constant already given by the researcher. For example, there is an example at the bottom of this slide. You may ask your respondents to divide 100 points among some brands according to preference for each brand. So there are three brands, brand A, B and C, and the total should be 100 points. So if a respondent gives 50 points to brand A, then 30 points to brand B, then the respondent will have to give only 20 points to brand C to make it a constant sum of 100. Another respondent who gives 60 to A and 30 to B will have to give 10 to C. Another who gives 70 to A and 20 to B will have to give 10 to C. So a sum of all the numbers should be a constant that has been already provided by the researcher. So this helps in understanding the relative importance of different attributes. If a respondent gives 50 to A, 40 to B and 10 to C, the researcher understands that in comparison to A, B is somewhat lower, but C is very low. And if a respondent gives 70 to A, 20 to B, it means in comparison to A, B is significantly lower. So this helps in understanding the relative preference. A constant sum scale requires respondents to divide a fixed number of points among several attributes corresponding to their relative importance or weight. So I hope this is clear with the example. Next, we'll discuss Likert scale. This is one of the most prominently used scale by the researchers. It was developed by Rensselaer-Likert. It is a measure of attitudes designed to allow respondents to rate how strongly they agree or disagree with the carefully constructed statements, ranging from very positive to very negative attitudes towards some objects. Again, we have an example. The important thing in Likert scale is that the statement should be very carefully constructed. You should have a statement with which the respondent could agree or disagree. You cannot have a statement for which a disagree or agree may not be relevant. For example, here is an example. You would buy healthy chewing gums if advised by your dentist. Strongly agree, strongly disagree to, strongly agree, in between disagree, uncertain and agree. Generally, five response alternatives: strongly agree, agree, uncertain, disagree and strongly disagree. Although the number of alternatives may range from 3 to 9. So in this case, it is very important to understand that this statement should be very carefully constructed. You would buy healthy chewing gums if advised by your dentist. Someone can agree or disagree with this statement. On the other hand, if you say, how do you feel about a healthy chewing gum, or how would you like to buy a healthy chewing gum, so for that, strongly agree or strongly disagree would not be relevant. So this statement should be very carefully constructed, and this is a simple scale. If respondent disagrees, you can write 1. strongly disagrees. You can write one while giving this data to the software, and sorry, entering this data into the software. If respondent is uncertain, you can write 3, and if respondent agrees, you can write 4, and so on. Next scale we'll discuss is semantic differential scale. In this scale, respondents react to some concept using a series of 7-point bipolar rating scale. Why we say it is bipolar? Because there are two opposite words on two opposite ends. Bipolar adjectives like good, bad, modern, old-fashioned, clean, dirty anchor the beginning and the end of the scale. So these are two poles, and those two poles have words which have opposite meaning. That is why this is called bipolar. So inconvenient location to convenient location, low price, high price, and so on. So this is 7-point bipolar scale. So there are, you can see there are 7 dashes between two statements or between two words or set of words. So a respondent can mark anywhere in between these two set of words, and wherever the respondent marks, we can understand that respondent is thinks something close to that word. For example, the first example in this case, if you ask about a store, then one is inconvenient location and other pole is convenient location. So if respondent ticks somewhere close to convenient location, it means respondent perceives that the store's location is convenient. If respondent ticks somewhere close to inconvenient location, it means respondent perceives its location inconvenient. So closer to the word, it means the attitude is more strong. As it goes away from the word, it means attitude is less strong. Anywhere in between, it means again the respondent is indifferent, uncertain, not clear about that particular attribute for that particular store or for that particular thing. So again, second example is low price. Respondent perceives the price low or high for a store maybe. So if just the dash next to the low price, it means strong perception that the price is low. Next, not very strong perception that price is low. Next, somewhat perception that the price is low, and so on. So this is how semantic differential scale works. We'll discuss other scales in next lecture. Thank you.